In 353 AD, the ninth year of the first Ring era of Emperor Mu of the Eastern Jin Dynasty, known as the Yonghe era, Wang Xizhi wrote the Lantingji Xu, or the preface to the poems composed at the Orchid Pavilion. It was considered by later generations as the number one running script in the world. Since then, calligraphers from the Tang, Song, Yuan, Ming and Qing dynasties have greatly admired it and have repeatedly copied, studied and pondered it.
Yonghe 9年岁在癸丑，暮春之初，老夫与众友人在此地曲水流沙，仰观宇宙之大，俯察品类之盛。游目骋怀，举视听之余，着实畅快呀！哈哈哈哈哈哈！哈哈哈哈哈哈！然，今日盛世，俯仰之间，以为沉寂，众人竟不知，老之将至，少，长。死生，
人生若白驹过隙，
你我又该如何自处？古人云：“死生。”已大矣。不知以死生为虚诞，其蓬殇为妄祝。后之视今，亦犹今之视昔啊。
今日奉大唐皇帝之命磨兰亭，
看岁字第一笔中空，
可字现断笔，
可想右军书此帖时心态通达，每阅此帖
宛若身临其境，字美文美，情景交融，难怪大唐皇帝称赞兰亭集序尽善尽美，对他
心魔手追。
双钩填墨，吾必将以吾之技艺传兰亭之风采。
天下书家，无一人能入我米元璋之法眼。但我奉兰亭集序为天下法书第一。兰亭集序清润，亦有秀气，转折与锋芒皆备，此等境界非知书者所不能到啊。
前人法说古朴有余，秀美不足，而兰亭雄秀之气出于天然。故知以死生为虚诞，齐彭殇为妄作。右军早就洞透人生苦短，告诫我后辈必当勤勉，不能空留枉然。
到我釜山这一辈，想要创新，难呐！仰观宇宙之大，俯察品类之盛，所以游目骋怀，游目骋怀。创新还需回到书法之正脉，我自幼敬右军忠孝之名，作字先作人，人齐字自古，这书法的正脉就藏于兰亭之中。
此地有崇山峻岭、茂林修竹，又有清流激湍，一带左右，虽无丝竹管弦之盛，一上一涌，亦足以畅叙幽情。
书是意，所以情怀，其志其
志，
后之兰者，亦将有感于斯文。
那为什么王羲
Why is 王羲之's 兰亭集序 considered the number one writing script in the world?
第一个是王羲之和他所代表的，就兰亭序所代表的行书。
First, the running script represented by Wang Xizhi's Lantingji Xu was created at a critical point in history. It was a time when running script was becoming mature and reaching a very high level. Wang Xizhi's brushwork showcased the potential of running script, including the structure of the characters and the variation of the strokes. Set in this historical context, it was inevitable that there would be a great work of running script produced at that time.
那个时期一定有一件伟大的新书作品。第二点呢，
Second, the Lantingji Xu is indeed a highly accomplished piece. Its brushwork, composition, and character structure achieved remarkable heights in the history of calligraphy.
书法史上是非常非常高。第三点呢，王羲之为代表的作品，它确立了一种古典的规范。
Third, works represented by Wang Xizhi's Lantingji Xu establish a classical standard. This norm, in simple terms, emphasizes symmetry and balance. It has been the mainstream aesthetic direction and trend for over 1,600 years. I believe it is the combination of these reasons that led to it being recognized as the number one running script in the world by subsequent generations.
How can we appreciate the Lantingji Xu in a modern-day context?
Lantingji Xu is a very high-quality
work.
The Lantingji Xu is an exceptionally high-level work that can be appreciated from various perspectives. Let me discuss its composition. What does composition mean? Simply put, it refers to the arrangement of individual characters within a work. If all the connections are rigid and uniform, the work itself would be quite rigid. Why is the composition of the Lantingji Xu so brilliant and subtle?
把任何一行兰亭序的文字做出它的轴线。If
we draw an axis through any line of text from the Lantingji Xu and connect them, we will discover a very delicate curve. At the same time, the shapes of the axes have some similarities, but they also change imperceptibly. The composition as a whole is very vivid.
非常的生动。
When writing running script, it is easy to lose control of one's movements. But when looking at Wang Xizhi's Lantingji Xu, there is almost no stroke that he did not have a technical mastery of. Let's look at the character Sheng, for example. Pay attention to the character Min in the lower part of it. There are two small vertical strokes in the middle of the character, followed by a horizontal stroke. If you look closely, you'll see that Wang Xizhi's vertical stroke goes down, and then picks up and falls down to write the horizontal stroke. Therefore, there is an overlapping cross between the horizontal stroke and the vertical stroke, showing the meticulousness of his brushwork. It conveys a sense of rhythm with various ups and downs, giving you a sense of its pace. Despite appearing calm on the surface, you can feel its continuous undulations, like ripples in water, giving you a sense of tranquility. This is the beauty you can experience from the Lantingji Xu.
那接下来呢，就让我们一同进入到临写的环节。
It's time for the 30 calligraphy enthusiasts here to write the Lantingji Xu and show our respect for this classic work and the sage of calligraphy.What are the most important considerations when copying the Lantingji Xu?
Due to the complexity of the Lantingji Xu, it is not possible to expect perfection right away. It is best to approach it in a step-by-step manner. For example, on your first attempt, focus on achieving the accuracy of your brush movement. Then, address issues related to the continuity of specific brush strokes and the overall structural variations of the characters.By gradually breaking down these issues and practicing diligently, a comprehensive approach can be mapped out.
Usually, people try to copy Wang Xizhi's works, including the Lantingji Xu, using today's accepted calligraphy techniques. However, this approach can be challenging because the techniques used are not precise.When copying a model of calligraphy, you need to carefully observe and imagine the movements involved in its writing. Only one type of movement can be closest to the author's original intention. When you can approximate his state of mind, you have the chance to create a work that closely resembles his style.
Let's take a look at the writing works of the calligraphy enthusiasts.